Welcome to Love Nesters and the sixth video in our Lake Superior Circle Tour series.
In our last video, we showed you the best activities at Pictured Rocks National Lakeshore.
Our adventure continues in Michigan as we explore Copper Country.
Littered with ghost towns and remnants of a bygone era, the Keweenaw Peninsula holds treasures just waiting to be discovered.
From abandoned mines and historic buildings
to breathtaking landscapes and hidden gems, our adventure through Michigan's Upper Peninsula is sure to inspire a trip of your own.
Hey, welcome back to Love Nesters. We are on the Keweenaw Peninsula, is that correct?
Yes, that is correct.
That is correct.
This portion they call the Upper Peninsula of the Upper Peninsula.
Oh, we are in the UP of the UP.
We are. And today we're learning all about copper. We're going to check out some mines. Can't wait to show it to you.
Thanks for being here.
The town of Houghton is known as the gateway to the Keweenaw Peninsula, the home of Michigan Tech University, and the birthplace of professional hockey. This is the Portage Bridge. It is the widest and heaviest double-decker vertical lift bridge in the world. Since rail traffic was discontinued, the lower deck is used to accommodate snowmobile traffic in the winter. Love it. Okay, so the snowmobile bridge is up right now, but you can see where you would go in on your snowmobile. So this is where the birthplace of professional hockey is. Someone who was a dentist, a former person from Canada, actually was the first to start paying people to come and play here, and that's why they're credited with the birthplace of professional hockey. And this is the gentleman who organized the world's first professional hockey league here in the Copper Country, James R. D. And the stadium is named after him. This stands in the site of the amphitheater that was here in 1902 until 1927 when it first burned down. The first hockey game was played in this arena in December 29th of 1902. The nearby Quincy Mine was one of the most successful and productive copper mines in the UP. It had the nickname of Old Reliable as it paid investors dividends every year from 1862 to 1920. Today, the mine is preserved as a historic site and offers above-ground self-guided free tours or below-ground guided tours.
So this is copper. This is what today is about. The hoist house was built in 1918, and I believe it is one of the largest in the world. This is the tram that I believe takes you down into the mines as part of your tour. I believe there are only three of these still in operation in the world, and one of them is right here in the UP.
These are the workhorses. Hold the tons and tons of copper out of the mines.
For all you snow lovers out here, here's a snow gauge. Believe it or not, the winter of 1978-79, it was 390 inches.
Last year, they did have a lot of snow. Look at that, very close to their record. These falls are in the town of Eagle River. They're right off of Highway 26. Very easy to get to, very pretty.
The Jam Lady has been a family-run business for over 200 years. They began selling jams from this storefront in the 1950s when an old post office was converted into a store. It is self-serve, on the honor system, and a very unique experience.
Michigan is known for their thimbleberry, so we're going to try this thimbleberry jam. So you pay here, or you can even make a checkout. Look at that. You can make a checkout to the jam lady. There's hey, even a credit card. You're paying, sir.
Honor system. This is only in the UP you get the honor system. This is awesome.
Jacobs Falls, super easy to get to. It's right off of Highway 26. Like right there's the road.
Right next to the falls is a Byzantine Catholic monastery known as the Holy Transfiguration of Skeet. Established in 1983, the monastery found its home in what was once a defunct resort on the shores of Lake Superior. At that time, it consisted of a single-room schoolhouse, three tiny cabins, and a humble hamburger shack. To raise money to sustain themselves, the monks transformed the old burger shack into a store that they aptly named the Jam Pot. What began as a small jam and jelly business has now grown to encompass a bakery, candy production, and even a coffee shop. From May to October, their doors welcome thousands of visitors eager to savor these heavenly treats. This is the Eagle Harbor Lighthouse. So this lighthouse has a museum as part of it, but they don't open until mid-June.
This is beautiful.
So this is what a calm day of Lake Superior. Oh, nice. Perfectly calm day on Lake Superior. Great pets. Has it been declanned?
Right,
he's sent it.
No, yeah. No, you're supposed to say no, he hasn't been. Whatever you do, do not startle him. Snickers is the mascot of the Delaware?
How old is he?
3 years old.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, Snickers is a small skunk school.
He's very sweet, actually.
Oh yeah, once you get over being afraid.
After a brief video, we selected our hard hats and began our self-guided tour.
Okay, 100 steps down into the mine.
Very wet and slippery.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe this is self-guided. Here we go. A little tip, it's $12 per person, and they only take cash or checks, so be prepared for that.
The Delaware Mine is an authentic copper mine in operation from 1847 to 1887. You are on a self-guided tour at 110 feet below ground.
So this mine, I believe, has
eight or 10, 10 different levels to it. We're only allowed on level one because the other levels are completely flooded. So we'll put a link in our description to the video. They actually put divers in on the lower level so you can see what it's like. This was a power drill. This would have been added later. The early mines would not have had a power drill.
This mine actually produced over 8 million pounds of copper.
Wow. Ooh. So this opening is a miner's crawl hole. It was used to move equipment from level to level. This is the pipe, the large pipe. This goes down into the shaft, and it would have had all the compressed air coming in to power the underground machinery. So partway through your walk through this mine, the lights actually dim to simulate the candlelight that the earliest miners would have been mining by.
Hey, we made it to the end of the Delaware Mining Company tour, the tunnel. It's a self-guided tour, and it is nice and chilly down here, so on a hot day it would be perfect.
We are learning a lot about the copper industry, which is really what fueled the economy here for quite some time.
What I took away was the poor workers that got paid 14 cents an hour working down here 12 hours a day and getting one day off Sunday to clear their lungs. Incredible.
Incredible. Makes you realize how blessed we all are.
We are so blessed.
But we're learning a lot about copper country. We hope you are too. If you're enjoying our adventures, please give this video a thumbs up. It helps others to find the channel.
Thanks for being here.
In its heyday, 1,100 people lived in the town of Delaware, all part of this mining operation. All that's left are two houses. They sure had some heavy-duty equipment. Wow, this was an impressive operation. You think about how far away from everyone this place was to build these structures.
The ruins of the Delaware Mining Company. This would have been fun to see during the heyday. Look at the huge structures.
This is all the waste product that they didn't use. It's all dumped here back in the 1800s.
Our travels took us all the way to Copper Harbor, the very tip of the Upper Peninsula. A lovely coastal town awaits, filled with breathtaking views of Lake Superior, shopping, and friendly people.
The Laughing Loon. How can you pass up a place that says the Laughing Loon on it? Ironically, that was my nickname in college.
This store had some great locally sourced products. Just outside of town, you can catch a glimpse of the Copper Harbor Lighthouse that is accessible only by boat, and to the place where US 41 ends or begins, depending on your point of view.
Welcome back to Love Nesters. Everyone's been on Highway 41 once in their life. Highway 41 starts here. We are at the beginning of Highway 41, right at the tip of Keweenaw Peninsula. From here all the way down to Miami, Florida. Oh, my back!
This is Copper Harbor. We're on top of Brockway Mountain, which is a hair south of Copper Harbor. And this is right at the tip of the peninsula. So it's our first time here. It is absolutely spectacular. So many of the locals said you have to go up Brockway Mountain to get the view. This is the one and only place in the peninsula. You can see both sides of the peninsula. You can see Lake Superior as well as the bay. It is incredible.
We are in Copper Harbor. We're about to have our lunch. This is a muffin. What type of muffin?
It's a cream cheese muffin that the monks made.
The monks from the Society of St. John.
Let's have it. I'm starving.
Thank you so much for joining us on this adventure.
And there's this wonderful cream cheese, even a little vanilla kind of flavor to it. Really good. Thanks for joining us today as we've explored the Keweenaw Peninsula. Hopefully we've shown you a lot of fun things you can do to spend a day here.
Thanks for being here.
In Calumet, you can get a glimpse of what life was like in a mining town in the 19th century and learn the stories of the people that worked in the mines. Historic landmarks like the Calumet Visitor Center, the Mining Museum, and the Calumet Theater remain from a bygone era.
So, fun fact, the town of Calumet at its peak had 35,000 people living here. Today, 7,000. So here it's talking about from Cornwall to Copper Country. Here's the pasty, and they've got it in a special container that they would have carried. Glad we got to eat one of those this trip.
The tools of the trade in the copper town. This is the packs down the snow so you can drive down it. And when you have 300 inches of snow, you really got to pack it down. All these wonderful tools for mining copper. What an industry copper mining was in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan.
It's neat to see the equipment that would have gone into the mines.
All right, so after a full day of looking at what the miners were doing and learning all about copper mines, it just seemed right to eat what the miners would eat. And that is a pasty.
And we have one of the best in all of UP. It's Randall's Bakery, which is in Wakefield. Randall's Bakery in Wakefield.
These are super, super hot. They're wonderful. They're a pie that's filled with meat and rutabaga and carrots and all kinds of goodness. And we love it with ketchup.
You love it with ketchup.
I love it.
I love it straight up.
Oh my gosh, so good. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for being here.
Join us in the next video when our trip around the Great Lake concludes with a visit to Wisconsin. We will explore the murals of Ashland, the waterfalls of Copper Falls State Park, and the town of Superior.
And we are in the Keweenaw.
No, Keweenaw.
Keweenaw
Peninsula.
And this video is sponsored by Dr. Scholl's Research.
Thanks for being here.
Hey, we made it. We are at the end of the 3-mile tour. Was it 3 miles?
No.
Oh, it felt like 3. The locals like to call it the big finger.
I'm going to have to cut that, you dork.
We're at the tip of the big finger.
We are at the tip of the Keweenaw.
Keweenaw. Cool.
Oh, thank you.
That was fun. You're so brave.
Thank you.
When he's in the mood, he cuddles right up with me.
Much like you.
Yeah.
I think your nickname should be Snickers.
Yeah, I think my nickname should be Snickers.
You just haven't been deglanded.